part of the Kingdom of Yugoslavia. It was triparted by the Axis powers, by Hungary, Germany, and Italy. They all took a part of the Slovene lands. In this video, I'm going to talk about Slovenia during World War II. And I'm now on location in Maribor, Slovenia. If you find it interesting, consider subscribing and also hit that notification bell. If you want to support me, you can go to my Patreon or my PayPal page. The links are in the description. What is now Slovenia was part of the Austro-Hungarian Empire. After the First World War, Italy got a peace, but the majority became part of the Kingdom of Serbs, Croats and Slovenes, later the Kingdom of Yugoslavia. As a province, it was known as Drava Banovina. In 1941, the Axis powers led by Germany invaded Yugoslavia and took down the state within 12 days. When that happened, representatives of the Slovene political party set up a national council trying to negotiate some special status, like the Croats, but the Slovenes were not successful. But the Axis, they had other plans, and thus, the former province of Yugoslavia was partitioned. I actually read that some villages that are today part of Slovenia then became part of the NDH, the independent state of Croatia, so that would mean that it was actually partitioned by four nations. But let's take a look at Hungary, Italy and Germany. Okay, Hungary took a small part in the northeast. The Germans, they took the north, and the Italians took the south, among which Ljubljana. The west of the country, what is now Western Slovenia, was already under Italian control since 1920. Let's start with the Hungarian part. The Hungarians, they annexed a part known as Prekmurje, with some 100,000 people living in it. Now, contrary to the other annexed part by the Hungarians were more permissive to the Slovenes. So the Slovene language was allowed in public and the Slovenes weren't deported, and there wasn't a policy of forced Magyarization, contrary to what happened in the other territory the Hungarians annexed from Yugoslavia. When the Germans took over Hungary in 1944, the Germans also took over that area, and Prekmurje became occupied by the Germans till the last weeks of the Second World War. The German part of Slovenia was intended to be incorporated into the German Reich. This formally happened in November 1941. The area was to be Germanized, or as the Nazis put it, re-Germanized, as it allegedly once had been. Reichsführer SS Heinrich Himmler was put in charge of a program of ethnic relocation. It had around 100,000 people and had thereby the largest population. The Germans claimed over 25,000 ethnic Germans, Volksdeutsche, lived in the area. In reality, it was about 10,000. Ethnic Germans from Italy and Romania had to be added to the German numbers. They, the Germans, planned to achieve these goals in three ways: by large-scale expulsion of undesirable Slovenes, especially the intelligentsia, by the transfer in of Volksdeutsche from the Italian annexed part of Slovenia, northeast Italy and east of southeast Europe, and by the Germanization of the remaining Slovene population. From June to November, large-scale deportations began. There is confusion about the numbers, but it is believed as many as 80,000 left the area, deported or on their own. Slovene schools and institutions were closed down, and the intelligentsia, such as Roman Catholic clergymen, were targeted. Reprisals followed for minor offenses, with 306 executions in 1941, such as the Maribor prison massacres, which happened all the way until 1945. The Italian southern part of Slovenia had around 350,000 people living in it. The Italians were much, much more permissive to the Slovene than the Germans were. Both the Slovene and Italian language were used in public, and also Slovene cultural institutions were kept, and thus normal cultural life continued. Yet Italian rule had its contradictions, because the leading fascist of the border region, Emilio Grazioli, he wanted to Italianize the Slovenes. The contradictions manifested by Italian rule, the failure of an approach that had little substance, the truncated territory of the province, and the comparative mildness of the occupation all prompted resistance that was almost impossible on the German side. The Slovenian section of the Yugoslav Communist Party, they set up the Liberation Front, the OF. The OF consisted of Christian socialists as well as left-wing liberals, but was later dominated by communists. By November, links were established with the Yugoslav government in exile, and Mihailovic, I'll talk about him later, was leader of the Chetniks. By the time, the partisans made their way across the border and they started liquidating people they believed to be traitors. The hills around Italian-controlled Ljubljana were swarmed with partisans who committed acts of sabotage and attacked isolated Italian outposts. The Italians declared the area an operational zone, and thousands of people were rounded up, mostly men of fighting age, and sent to internment camps. In the next year, the Italians undertook actions against the partisans, killing hundreds of them and having 100 casualties themselves. And as time progressed, Italian rule became more oppressive, and many Slovenes were sent to Italian concentration camps, either in Italy or Croatia. And then there's also collaboration. The Italians, they set up the Anti-Communist Volunteer Militia, in short the MVAC, also known as the White Guard, were Italians in this formation, also Slovenes. And they undertook actions against the communists. Supported by the Catholic Church, these anti-communists wanted to stop partisan terror. The situation that unfolded was described by historian Pavlovic. Civil war flared up in autumn, when both anti-communist defenders of the faith and communist-controlled liberators went out to win the uncommitted center of Slovene opinion, or to force it to come out with a clear choice. All in all, it left the Slovenes confused. Many expected and hoped the Allies to land, but that didn't happen. As Italy surrendered in 1943, the Germans took over the Italian territories. The Germans set up the Slovene Home Guard. Many former MVAC members joined this formation. By September 1944, it had around 13,000 members in its ranks. They had to swear a solemn oath to the SS and the German police to fight the partisans. But many did so under duress, because it would make them suspects in eyes of the Western Allies. And then there was also the Black Hand, which was established in several cities in 1944, which basically hunted down members of the OF. In April 1945, the Germans left Slovenia. And Slovenia was liberated, but not by the Western Allies, nor by the Soviets, but by the Slovene partisans. And even after World War II in Europe came to an end, there was fighting between the pro-Axis units and the partisans. The latest battle that occurred in Slovenia, that was part of the Second World War, occurred mid-May, the Battle of Poljana. I hope to cover that in the future someday. If you want to make that happen, you can support me. You can do so via Patreon or via PayPal. The links are in the description. If you want to know about other countries during World War II, you can click right here. I have a playlist for you. I want to thank you for watching, and do not forget to subscribe. And all the best from Maribor, Slovenia.